Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to actually add the routing and we will create a HTTP service using which we will be able to send the user payload to the APIs. Okay, so this is like very basic integration we are going to do. We built this application from scratch, so for beginners this course or this particular set of videos can be very helpful who are learning React, wanted to write their own application with the full stack technologies. Okay, we already have the APIs created using Node.js and Express. Now we are writing the front end using React. Okay, so in the previous video we were able to create this form. From this form we are actually sending the payload, whatever you have submitted in the text field, username, first name, last name. So this form is now working. When you clicking on to the submit, we are able to capture all the values which has been entered here. Right, these values are coming. Now what we need is, we just need to send this data to an HTTP call so that our user can be created. Before that, what we can do is we can have a routing setup, because we are going to have a single page application where we will have user profile, user registration, and then we will also need a screen where we can display the list of blogs and a place where user can create a new blog. Okay, so for routing setup, we can use the React Router DOM. Okay, and we can import few things. So first of all, what you can do is you can install React Router DOM in particular client. So npm install React Router DOM. Now you can import the router here. I will put router as a browse router, and here we can wrap it around. So the router should be the parent one, and you will be rendering all the child component inside it. Now we don't need these fragments, we can remove. Okay. Now what we are doing is, header component is something which is common. What we can do is we can replace this child component. So we can wrap few things inside our switch block. Okay. Like if a particular route is this switch exact path. Okay. So if path is forward slash, then component which we are going to render is, component which you will render is something. So here we can create multiple switch blocks. If path is exactly matching with home, this also we can create. And we need to create one path. This is not switch, this should be route. And this is also going to be route, and here we will wrap it around a switch block. So here switch should be in camel case, so we'll just wrap all the routes inside a switch. Okay, now this is our first route and this is second route home. Similarly we can create one another. Okay, let's create it as a blog. And another will be a screen where user will be able to create a blog. So here we will pass user ID. Okay, now we need to create a three components for them. One component we already have, which is container component, that we can use for blog and home page. This is like a home page, this is a blog page, and this is a user ID, right? So here we can say we can create a user container component where user can create a blog and can see all the blogs which he has created earlier. User container.js, this is what we are going to write, create user container.js. This we can create inside component. Okay, this is container. So similarly, for now let's keep it the same. What we are going to do is, we don't need all these methods in user container. We can still have some kind of a state which will be fetching the blogs data of user. This we can replace with something from here, like there is a list item we need. So list group we can use. I mean, we are going to show the list of all the blogs which user has already created. something like this, so we can create a list group and we'll import list group from React Router, sorry, from React Bootstrap. I'll just format this format document with okay. So right now we don't have on click method on this. Here we have a list group. I need to set up a formatter. You can either use PrettyRC. So here we are actually using list group, so we can import list group instead of all these things. List group, okay, this is fine. So we are actually using container component. So here it can be user container component. This is the place where we will be creating a new blogs, and we will be able to see the existing blogs which user has already created. So this we can import user container. Okay, and we will just pass this in the component definition. Now if we just run this, let's see if we are able to pass something. Compiling, router is not defined. This is coming from app.js. I'm really very sorry, it should be route. Why I'm putting router? So it should be route inside a switch. I think it was typo while doing autofill. Okay, route is not defined, which we can directly get from here. We can also get switch. Okay, so we got all required props. Router is still not defined, line 18. Let's see what it is. Router, so we are getting router from router as a browser router. Why it is complaining still? Okay. Router is not defined. I can use browse router in this case. Okay, instead of without creating alias, switch. Okay, duplicate declaration of switch. Okay, I'm not using this switch. Sometimes these imports automatically get added when you actually compile the code. Now new bar is not defined, never used, that is fine. So if we just launch the application, we should be able to see the container component. When you go to blog, again you should see the container component, but when you go to this user ID, you will see the user container component. Okay, you can put any particular name. Now you can see all things are fine. Okay, this is coming two times. Now let's see why it is coming two times. So this is exact path. Okay, this is matching, right? So we don't need exact path for this one. This header we are having inside switch block, we have these three components. Okay, this one, this is the duplicate, right? This is why it was coming twice. Now switch block, browse router, header is common. Header we want everywhere. So now if I render this, then it is coming once. This is what we wanted. Now we have this component. Now this component can be triggered. And now let's see what error. Submit user ID is not defined. That is correct, because now we are not defining. We have moved these components to the router. Okay, so what we need to do is in the container. So for making API call, we can use Axios. Axios is a library. We can just install it using npm install --save Axios, and we can write axios.get, axios.put, post, delete, all these methods. Like here we are making axios.post. Similarly, what all other methods we can trigger, like axios.get is there. We just pass the URL. You don't need to pass the payload. And whatever the data we are getting. So now what we are going to do is we will get the user ID once user is created. So we will access, we will just move to a different route using this dot cross dot history dot push, and we will move to a blog route, and that route is something like blog, and here we are passing the ID. So in that case, it will be coming in the backtick. And here I can pass the ID of it. So here we got underscore ID. So it will go to the another route, and we are passing ID as a route parameter. So in that component, which is user container, in component did mount or whatever the method you will write, like here I'm writing component did mount. Here I can access console.log this.props.match.params.userid. This is how you can access the user ID coming there. So I can do this.props.match.params. I mean, very long one. So I got the user ID. Now I can make an API call to get logs information, right? Here I created a user, I got the ID. Now in this user container component, in component did mount lifecycle method, I can make an API call, and here it will be, I will be passing user ID and I will be passing a post. So here I'm doing HTTP get. So I will be getting all the post which user has created. Okay, so what I will do is in the response.data, I can just do this dot set state, and I will be getting all the posts. So posts equal to response.data. And once you receive the posts, here you can iterate here. I mean, you can just run a map inside a list group. We have list group and list items. These all are list items. So what we can do is I will just copy one, I will remove others, and I can run map here. And what map will be doing, this dot state dot posts dot map. Okay, here I will be getting I and index. And I can render all these items. Okay, here you can just display your information like I dot content or title. Okay, so this is how we can actually get the data about the blogs of that user. Based on route parameter we are getting it, then in component did mount we are making a call. Here you can just put some conditions like if posts are not there, right? So we have to do this only if there are posts. If user posts are not there, then you can show the message, okay, no posts are available. You can create a new one. And here we can provide a form like post create component, which will be same as user create component, where we are just giving a form to the user to create a blog post. I mean, that time it was for registration. Now we can give the same thing. We can write the same kind of component for creating the post. Okay, it should be simple post create. So here we had container. So similarly, you can create a post create component. .js. I mean, we can just follow the same same file naming. That should be good. Here post container, we can just say post create. Now in post create, we can actually first copy the container only, then we will change whatever is needed. We don't need this, we just need a container and title. So here we have post title, post content, and here we will be calling the same method. Here we will be passing the user and we will be creating a post. API users, here it will be user ID will be getting, and posts, it will be HTTP post call, and we will be passing this dot state, which has is having title and content, same thing. And then you can navigate back to that same user list page. I mean, this is a child component, so we don't need to do this routing because we are on the same component. We will just check, okay, there should be no any error while creating the post. And error handling we can do in the catch block. here if you want to deal with something, then we can do here to be done. Okay, here we are making API call. Now we need a title and content, so we just needed two text fields, no, 3-1. Here we can replace it with the title, and here it can be content. Name of this particular field will be content. It is pretty much easy now. Now, because we have seen this particular form earlier also, this is title and this is content. Just placeholders on change form control. It should be content from the state. It should be a title which is coming from the state. Okay, pretty much straightforward. Handle submit. We are calling, we are getting both the properties, and we are creating the post. And this component we are rendering here. So this like post is below to this list component. Okay, here you can create one button which will show and hide the creation of post. Here you can create one button, add new post. So here you can create a new flag property, add new post, which is initially false. Okay, now you will have some kind of a button which will say add new post. And on click, you can actually toggle this particular property. Okay, on click, what you are doing is you will be just setting up this dot set state. Here we can also do this if you are wondering, this dot state dot add new post. Okay, so we are just toggling whatever we had earlier, add new post. So this will actually set the button to true, add new post to true. So if add new post is true, then we are going to render this component. So this is how we write the React components. Add new post, if this is true, then render this component, otherwise do not render this component. Okay, pretty much simple. Okay, so this is all. Now from the next video, we might be talking about something else. We can explore the functional component. In the functional component, now we will be start using the different kind of hooks. We have till now, we have created all these as a class-based component. We are writing the state here and using the lifecycle methods, component did mount, derive state from props, should component update, right? But in the functional component, we don't need all these kind of lifecycle methods. We have hooks to manage the state. We have use effect hook to do all these kind of side effect, making an API call and all different things. So we are going to explore functional component in coming videos with hooks, context, APIs and all. I hope my videos and my trainings are helpful for you guys, how we are actually managing the state, props, how we are writing the component, how we are writing the form. In one of my video series, I'm going to cover React Formic, which is a library to create React forms with all different kind of validations. Everything is there, you just need to implement the form. Whatever the complexity the form is having, everything can be implemented with a React Formic library. Okay, thanks everyone.